So Sim is going to come talk to you. She's actually with Non-Traditional Student Services, so she's really focusing her talk on private scholarships available, and there are a lot. So this is the really important part, but this is the money part.
Hi, welcome everybody to UNL. Thank you for coming this evening. Real quick, under my time constraints, I'm going to highlight my lovely assistant, my daughter Alexis. She's going to hand out some. Like they said, I am actually the Non-Traditional Student Programs Coordinator at the Office of Campus Life. I'm here to give you just a quick overview of scholarships. The number one question I get asked is, are there scholarships for grad school? Yes, there is! Yay! Yes. Why? Well, I think because funders are becoming more cognizant of the fact that very few bachelor's degrees are turnable anymore. We have to go on to get master's degrees. So there are a lot available. On one handout, you're going to get about grad school scholarships. These are all our internal scholarship opportunities. These are UALR scholarships, funded by private scholarship funders or some of the colleges. So I'm not going to read this through this, but do look through it. There are a lot of opportunities here on our campus. Also, on the second page, you're going to see a list of scholarship resources. National and Arkansas. So definitely go to these websites and look. Now, on the other handout, they're just talking about finding scholarships. What are scholarships? Well, free money. You don't have to give it back. It's awesome. Real quick, some tips. Finding scholarships is a numbers game, okay, guys? It's not only a numbers game in identifying them, but it's a numbers game in applying for them. Think of the rule 10. You have 100 opportunities identified, 10 that you qualify for, you're going to apply for, and you're going to get one out of that. Okay? So don't give up. Don't get discouraged. I run into that a lot. I do a lot of scholarship workshops for the undergrads. And I say, I'm applying over and over again. I never get it. Why? Well, usually the reason is the essay. A lot of times it's the essay that holds you back, and we'll talk about that real quick. And the bottom line on this one is to get more, you have to apply for more. Okay? Small is a new big. Don't think about just getting a whole big scholarship for $10,000, right? Because everybody's applying for that one, right? Like those little ones. There's not as much competition. If you will go to my website, my contact information is on the back of this one flyer. You are going to see success stories. Like I said, I've done many, many workshops. Go on there. See what they've done. I had one girl, I never thought of this. She Googled scholarship for that's her hobby, is needle pointing. Guess what? There was, and she got $250 for needle pointing. It's awesome. So it can be done. Think outside the box. The small ones and the big, so go for the small ones, where there's less competition. Build that portfolio. Really, and you're going to need it, because you guys are all going on for your doctorates, right? Yay! So go ahead and build that portfolio now. Just be ready. So have those essays ready. And then you're just going to tweak them to each individual scholarship. So remember, customize your answers for each of the applications. Be sure to answer the question, not some random question that you should fill out your essay about that. We get that a lot too. I read a lot of scholarship applications in that space. The devil's in the details. It's like I was saying, read right. Guess what happens if your scholarship essay comes in and there's a grammatical error in the very first sentence? Guess what happens to it? File 13, real fast. We won't even go beyond. At this level, there's absolutely no room for mistakes. So proof those essays and your scholarship applications. I've been reading a lot of, not for our college, for another university's study abroad, and they always put, what's your country of destination? And they put, United States. You're in the United States. See, so there you go. That was automatically dismissed because they did not fill out the application correctly. They could not read the questions and fill it out. So be sure to get that all out of the correct name. Scholarships, sure, searching is actually a year round. Our internal, the ones that are on this cover folio now, yes, the deadline will be March the 1st. Point one. But external, there are four different spreadsheets of scholarships, external scholarships that are out there in the world for everybody, all right? There's one specifically that says scholarships for graduate students. I quickly did this over the last couple of days. I identified 81 scholarships I asked that applied to education grad students. Wow. Is that fast? That fast? On this handout, on the second page, these websites, I found those in 5 minutes today, guys. And they all had this on there for grad school. Amazing opportunities for scholarships. So definitely go after it. 500 words. The last page is all about writing your essay. Most essays are 500 words, and they are crucial. This is where you're selling yourself. This is where you are saying to the funder, please invest in me. It's like buying stock at the company, right? You're going to look into that company, make sure it's a good solid investment before you give them money. Same thing with you guys. The funder's going to look up and get a good financial investment. Are they going to graduate in a reasonable amount of time? A lot of them look at the type of degree you're getting. Are they getting a degree that's going to lead to employment? Later on, you kind of worry about that. You're in grad school, you're specialized. It's more of an undergraduate and undergrad majors. But really, this is where you're going to sell yourself. We've had bumps in the road. We've had some academic doubts. This is where we're going to explain this away. And as non-traditional students, funders are very aware of the fact that we had to go back into the workforce, and we come back to school, or whatever it is. But your essay is your chance to sell yourself. Real quick, just avoid using statements as I'm going to talk about it. This essay is about. Be sure to really show those three bullet points I have on there. Really, really show those in their essay. And of course, cutting and polishing, you guys know all about editing, cleaning up your essay. We have a wonderful writing center here on campus that you can go to get help. And then at the bottom, I just put a couple of sample essay introduction paragraphs and you can also tell the difference between the two, the first one. So, there are tons and tons of opportunities out there, guys. This one is our internal. There's plenty of opportunities. If you go to my website, I did not want to print that off because it's a huge document. Go to my website. And like I said, I uploaded that just right before I walked over here. So there's a spreadsheet there. I'm going to convert it to a Google Doc. So it'll be a living document, so you guys can just click on the links to go for it. Definitely, think outside the box. Let me do this one last thought. I had a student come in to me a couple days ago. And she's an undergrad, she's getting ready to finish it up. And she was seeking financing for her grad degree. Well, she's getting help from a nonprofit here in Moorlaw. Traditionally, that nonprofit doesn't offer funding for grad school. So we thought about it, we talked about it. She goes, Cinda, could you write me a letter to that nonprofit pleading my case about why I need to go on to get my master's in professional technical writing? Sure, I can do that. Persuasive enough to decide to fund your master's degree. Think outside the box, guys. Ask. Ask your employers. Hey, will you help me? Will you sponsor me for my master's degree? If you're an educator, if you're a teacher, if you know about teaching there, that's all on that handout. Check into all that is another way. So there's plenty of opportunities to be in my home. So if you guys have any questions, feel free to contact me. I'll be happy to help. You guys are all Montrads, feel free to contact me, email me, call me, whatever. I'll be happy to answer your questions.